The markers scattered around the Plaza de la Constitución in St. Augustine tell the history of the nation's oldest city. The executive director of the Lincolnville Museum and Cultural Center has been eager for another marker to be added to the collection.
It was actually our team when we went to EJI.
A marker to remember Isaac Barrett, the only reported lynching in St. Johns County.
Yeah, but the marker has been sitting in my closet here at this museum for over a year. It's here. It has been here. We were just waiting for a date.
A marker once stood near the Shands Bridge, where the lynching happened in 1897, but it was stolen in 2018, less than 36 hours after it was put in place. Regina Gell Phillips says the Equal Justice Initiative donated a second marker to replace the first one. Phillips went on to the city of St. Augustine to request the new marker be placed in the Plaza de la Constitución.
What a wonderful place to educate people about some of the racial injustices in our community that we're trying to overcome, because the point of this marker is reconciliation.
The city commissioners unanimously approved the concept in August 2019. A lot happened after the vote, the pandemic, and the social justice movement, which led to revisiting the relocation of the Confederate monuments, putting plans for the Isaac Barrett marker on hold.
The city commission has not pressed me to bring the item back, but it is time to reconcile this with the groups that are advocating for it.
An email chain from March 2020 shows there was a visual mock-up of the marker in the plaza. The final plan was then supposed to go back to the commission for approval. However, City Manager John Regan is now recommending the marker be placed near the Shands Bridge, where the first marker was stolen and where the lynching happened.
I think that what's important is the telling the true and accurate history. And by being in the Central Plaza, it will convey a message that it happened here.
In his letter, Regan also claims the act was committed over 75 years after the period of relevance identified for monuments to be placed in the plaza per city code. Phillips says the letter was like a slap in the face.
Are we angry? Yeah, we're angry. And we're not getting ready to just, you know, play dead and pretend like this didn't happen.
Regan plans to present his recommendation to the city commissioners at its meeting at the end of the month for a final vote. I'm Haley Harrison, First Coast News, on your side.